I love Tmux. I create a ton of content around it. I built my own session manager, and I love that I can use it anywhere, locally, remotely, even random servers. It's always there. But sometimes I have to admit it's lacking in some ways. Seeing Zellij's amazing advancements and features makes me wish I had some of them in Tmux already. So instead of just hoping, I decided to build one myself, and I've been loving every minute of using it. Before we jump in, if you like the plugin I'm about to show, the best way to support it is by giving it a quick star on GitHub. The link is in the description. If you use it and find anything that should be fixed or improved, don't be a stranger and please open an issue. With that out of the way, let's start introducing Tmux Floax. Meet Tmux Floax, a new Tmux plugin built to provide a floating pane over Tmux, supporting all the functionality you'd expect from a floating companion just like other tools provide. It features a distinct style and colors to help you separate it from the working environment underneath, and every bit of its style is configurable through plugin settings. The inspiration came from Zellij's floating panes, providing a custom floating pane in addition to the multiplexing standard features. And while Floax still doesn't feature a stacked multiple floating pane options like Zellij does, it offers all the comfort of an additional copilot session for side processes. However, it does something way, way cooler. Before I show you what it is, let's address the elephant in the room. You might be thinking, I can just use another Tmux window or pane or even a hidden split to zoom in and out. And you're 100% right, but I'm particular about these things. When I saw a floating pane in Zellij and realized Tmux has pop-ups, it reminded me of NeoVim's most important rule, the least keystrokes principle. To demonstrate what I mean, let's create a split below my code, like most IDEs, and run my code there. I'll also zoom out, because with Tmux I can easily manage my screen real estate. Now, to see my logs again, I have to 1. Zoom out, 2. Move to the pane, 3. Zoom into the logs, 4. Zoom back out, 5. Move back into my code, and then zoom in again. With Floax, I'd simply pop the pane, go back to my code. Even another window, which is quicker in terms of keystrokes, requires a dedicated logs window. I don't like this, as this makes me feel like I'm leaving my context. There's a great reason why people love floating windows. They make it feel like you're never leaving. You can still see your environment underneath, and the user experience feels smoother. This concludes my why, now let's explore the how. Floax under the hood is a pop-up that attaches itself to a running session. This means that you can use it like the standard Tmux session by splitting the window vertically or horizontally, change the pane sizes and everything else you expect from a non-floating window. It also comes with layout options mapped on top, allowing you to go full screen with Ctrl-Alt-F, resetting back with Ctrl-Alt-R, changing the size of the pane to become bigger or smaller with either B or S respectively. Speaking of another integration I really liked recently, Wix Studio just launched an integration with Figma. Ever wished your stunning Figma designs would seamlessly transform into fully functional websites? Meet Wix Studio, a powerful web creation platform built for professionals like you. With the new Wix Studio plugin, you can now easily import your Figma designs directly into Wix Studio. Watch as your designs come to life with advanced features like animations and custom cursors, making your websites truly, truly unique. No more grind. Wix Studio smart tools let you focus on creativity while ensuring responsiveness and high-end results you won't get anywhere else. It's never been easier to take on complex projects and deliver impressive websites that wow any visitor. Discover more at wix.com/studio and watch the This is Studios video for a deep dive into all the amazing features built on Wix Studio. I want to thank Wix, and with that, let's jump back into Floax. When compared to a standard Tmux pop-up, Floax isn't a temporary solution. Using its dedicated session, it keeps a persistent shell that you can hide and bring back on top when you need it. The hidden status can always be shown back if you like to further customize the running session. If we pop up the session manager, this is SessionX, by the way, another plugin I made a couple of months back for easy processing of a lifecycle management of sessions. SessionX shows the scratch session in a list of existing other sessions. If you don't have SessionX, you can always see Floax scratch session from within the default Tmux session previewer. Okay, convinced? Let's see how you can get Floax and install it in just 3 seconds. Head over to your Tmux config, where we're going to use TPM, the Tmux plugin manager, for installation. If you don't have TPM set up, catch the video above where I go through setting up Tmux from scratch, including TPM, ready for other plugins. Once ready, we're going to add omrxx/tmux-floax. That's going into the list of TPM by prefixing it with set-g at plugin. You can see additional configuration that's available in the plugin's docs. I already have configured setting the pane size, colors, and prefix. The last line that I'm changing right now is Floax's option to follow the current path each time you pop it, if you like changing according to the current running session's working directory. After sourcing the new configuration updates, it's time to run prefix and I to instruct TPM to start installing everything. Do note that with prefix and capital U, you can tell TPM to update plugins. It'll let you choose whether you want to update all of them or just a certain one. Floax is a rather simple bash script that you can take your time to read and add functionality if you like. Most of my personal usage with it is running what I call sidecar processes, like a Redis server, for example, to use with my app. And since I can always add splits or windows, I'm not limited to one service running in the floating pane. And while adding more windows like I'm running here with the top process, for example, make sure you're not overdoing this as it can get quite confusing, especially without the Tmux status bar on top. If you have any questions, features in mind, or fixes you'd like to contribute, I'd be thrilled if you head over to Tmux Floax on GitHub page, start and open an issue with your thoughts and ideas. And while you're at it, please also do the same with Tmux SessionX, which is already getting attention and love from amazing contributors and users of its own. There's something important I want to reiterate here. Tmux is only means to an end. Personally, I can go on for hours building plugins like Floax for pop-ups or SessionX for session management. I'll spend nights covering Zellij, its new features, and how I can incorporate them into my own workflow. And while you can check out my workflow in the video mentioned up here, do keep in mind that it's only relevant if you feel you're enjoying your work and that it helps you become more productive. Don't just take my advice because I'm just some dude on YouTube. Build your own process and workflow. Add only tooling that makes sense to you. I hope this idea resonates with you. I'm more than happy to hear your thoughts, so go ahead and leave a comment. Please subscribe if you liked it, and also give this video a thumbs up. It helps me a lot in understanding what you guys like and consider valuable information. I'll leave my entire playlist of terminal productivity so you can pick what works for you. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.